And let's see in game two here if it pays off.
Here we go.
We need some noise, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, game two about to begin.
Northeast.
Who will come out on top? We saw Strugs with the heel off at the end last game. For game number two, which player will rise above the rest and secure that victory royale? We know some players who have some points so far. We'll get a full standings update for you as soon as possible for everyone at home, because I'm sure you're looking out for that. But either way, let's get into the action.
In the bottom right here, our winner from last game, Strugs, dropping in. He's looking at the southeast corner of the map, maybe a Paradise Palms, maybe hitting the like the mini junk junction of the south-southeast of that. He could even land up on top of the structures up here and just see if he can dig up a chest or two.
No weapon in hand. Eliminations already have begun. I believe Wheats and DMO have both been eliminated already.
Trying to go for the drop on his opponent there. The shotgun pops. He goes down to a... Earlier, though, at the top down, you see Mars City's building up top. Gets a very long-range shot with that shotgun there.
That's a beautiful inventory to have. He doesn't quite finish the elim yet.
He got a shotgun tag a little too far away to secure that elimination one shot from that double barrel, but it's super effective if you are close enough to the target. And it finds him, gets the 145. Almost doesn't even matter.
That's
how
a lot
much
of damage, just as my professional opinion.
Puts him at 56 HP, I believe. And the Horrifying goes down to Jack's shotgun push there.
A load out like this, he's hoping for late game. Here's a look at Vivid. Someone who has won multiple times in the early weeks of Summer Skirmish. He's going to go for it all. LMG now in hand as he's hearing the shields get popped. Try to juke his opponent right there, his goal. Hit the close wall, force his opponent to build out and try to catch him as he builds above. Vivid keeping this high ground, he knows that is everything, but unfortunately, that third party as someone has just peeked from up above.
He may or may not have realized that there were shots from above here. And right now in this game, by the way, two players with three eliminations, Mars Cities and Top Boy, which means they both have a single point apiece. Trying to defend against these shots from the player underneath him. The low shot count that he was getting, that was coming at him, you notice he never built the triangles to double layer the floor.
Yeah.
That was, I think, the expectation there from Vivid is that,
ooh,
what a snipe. The expectation being that he doesn't necessarily, he didn't think he's going to get shot at enough that he has to double layer. That means his opponent might be low on ammo, and he can disengage. They're going to disengage because they don't want to necessarily hit the shots. Use that bolt action to take out the ramp as his opponent was building up, and it forces them to drop down. They're closer to the zone. They're going to build back away from him, and he's trying to keep pressure on them.
Vivid knows he's in a very rough spot right now.
He was just engaging with this player.
Yep.
He did hit the body shot, so they're at that time, a max of 95 HP remaining is a hit for 105. Blue bolt action, and the grenade launcher going to come out. That's in the top left. Tilted, looking hot right now. Cheeto securing an elimination, the first one this game. Vivid is boxing in.
He's made it into the zone, and this is actually where he becomes one of the best players in the world. Don't get me wrong. Vivid is great throughout the whole game, but where he truly, truly excels is when it gets into little battles like this. These one-by-ones, these quick edits, these maneuvering around the close areas. Look at this. People all around
him. Players in that tower, and Vivid is going to stay down below, maybe wait for a third-party opportunity, because if these two are going to engage each other, he doesn't have to push.
Still 48 left.
So you're Vivid, who was in the bottom of that tower.
Telling you, this is where this man works, man.
Gets
destroyed the roof. The Clinger then fell on in, and the player got damaged and had to escape. This was Blue T earlier on with that double barrel up close and personal. Bye-bye, my friend. That was how Fuse was eliminated from this one.
Punisher sitting on top one by one. He's got the window edited. He's using a little bit of third person to look out, see if he can spot people rotating. And that's high enough, he might be able to sneak out. Yep, he can crouch walk out of that just barely and look for a shot. He's trying to sneak his way out. He's going to close it up. These players closing their gates behind him because someone could sneak in.
Left.
And you're starting to see a lot of these chambers built up. The roofs, the little one-by-one boxes, and the shots come out. Max is just going to spam down his walls. Gets Sinful caught right at the wall.
This would be for 2 points at 5+ limbs. He's made it into the zone, but he's got no materials. He's got to win an engagement here.
He
knows it. He's going for it all. This is kind of an all-risk play right here. Can he get the victory?
Well done. Ashton goes down to Jack's drum gun, the shotgun.
And look at what he's rewarded with. Lupo, shields.
600 plus
600
wood.
600 plus wood. He had to do that. He had no choice. And not only does it earn him another point, but it earns him a chance to win this game.
Even.
And now he's dead. I'm going to stop complimenting
people. You need to stop it, Jack. You've lost two players so far.
The verticality adds a whole nother level. People are going to drop like flies here. From 20 players remaining, now down to just 13. It seems like the rest of everyone has made it on in, but I mean, they are all within inches of each other.
Mac actually goes down to the storm last second there. That's 12 left. Two more players go down, and then everyone that's remaining gets 1 point. One more goes down to the storm. But the storm is still claiming players. 27 seconds left to the next
move. Reminds me of week one of the skirmish.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, KL.
The storm still here. It's going to move to the top of the hill still. And actually, that shot you just had was the direction that it's moving. So it's moving from builds to builds that are already there. And Nate Hill here, player from FaZe, down at the bottom. He's bandaging the med kit.
He's
going to
get that med kit off in the last second. Look at this.
Looking around. He has quite a bit of medium ammo left, 210 shots. Unicorn's flying across, looking to make it into the next storm. Builds. As he's flying, tries to establish himself. He just fell off the map. Top boy, getting tagged up, building the floors, trying to build himself a layer, but he hasn't double layered any of this. So if somebody looks up and starts to take some shots, or maybe sees where it's connected, he could get dropped early. Caro's looking back, editing himself through, trying to look for just sneak one shot in, but he cannot build. He's got five wood, two brick, and he goes down. Two more lost in the storm, eight players remaining, which means everybody that's left on your screen, as you see them, they're getting at least 1 point from game two.
Yep. And now the next question comes in, who will make it to our top three to earn themselves another point, and who will keep that victory royale? Look at this, blue tee all the way up top. He's just looking for free picks. When you're in the scenario, you have no intentions of dropping down unless someone forces you. He doesn't have a lot of metal left.
He's in a good spot for the next circle, though.
He is very, very close. And now he's going to actually get a little bit closer for a shotgun engagement.
Refire the rocket, try and shoot. He tried to shoot back behind where there wasn't necessarily a wall to get some splash damage in on this player that's built in underneath him.
Oh, he wants this a limb now, too.
He does. It'll put him at three.
Yep.
Plus, it'll put him to fifth place, and he's going to get it. That's 2 points in one shot there.
Yep. And now he's one more placing away from another point, which would put him at three this game. This is a brilliant performance right now from Blue Tee. We're in our top four again, folks. You already see Flame has five limbs. He's earned himself three already. He's one more placing away from earning another point.
Third here, blocking the rockets.
That wall just barely blocks the rocket in time.
The next circle, this is the one that closes all the way down. So players that have HP healing remaining and gets caught off guard by Nate Hill, sneaks inside and gets the Elim, puts him at six. The second one on Powder, two HP remaining. Are you kidding me?
Nate 1v1. Hill, seven Elims this game, and there he goes.
Goes down to Blue Tee. What a finish. At that moment was actually leading in eliminations.
Yeah,
that's gotta feel good. He might not know that that Fugues had the most, but that's big. That's a big play. You see, he's got three limbs already on top of the win. It's going to put him at four, but it's not enough to push him to the two-point limb bonus.
Nate actually basically limbed himself there because he had to move with the zone.
He did.
That's a sign of game number three about to be underway. The battle bus has launched. Let's get on into it. We know Strugs took game one, Blue Tee with game two. Who's coming out on top in game number three?
It puts them in really good positions. Like you said, the top 33 from each of these qualifiers gets in the grand finals.
Yep.
So some of these players, we might not even realize it, but players like Blue Tee, Nate Hill, Strugs, they've already accrued enough points that they might be good to go. The point being, though, you can't get comfortable. You're going to see people that are still going to maintain the way that they played in previous matches. They're still going to drop into POIs that are maybe a little less populated. They're going to go for safe gameplay, and we're going to see that, I think, over the course of all of this, one to the north around this area. Now, Vivid is somebody that we've been talking about a lot, and this is early game. Vivid goes down.
Fluid, and then I'll get into what I was going to bring up. You see players trading damage right now. Drebin trying to stay alive. There's the quick headshot. Bye-bye carrots, and there's a golden legendary assault rifle for you as a reward. Drebin already two limbs. This could be the third right here if he can somehow take down Crypto, and it won't happen.
Build and counter and get up top. Goes for an edit and a peak shot.
Mount Marksman to the third party. Mark's been now dropped way, way low. He's trying to pop minis in time. Not going to happen.
I believe the third party might be Blue Team, that you can't wait too long.
I'd love to if we can potentially just pull up the map for a second. And
that's the snipe.
That was the replay from earlier.
That shot from Hysteria. A very, very quick snipe.
I'd love to potentially bring up the map when we get a chance, when some of the action dies down for a moment, just to see how central this zone is. As Freak is going to go ahead and try to push the agenda on this engagement. Does he get the wall down? He does, but the player should just build above him.
Tickling each other as they try and move inside the zone at the same time. Difference here, Dimebox is a ton of builds.
Oh my
gosh. A ton of materials left. He's going to go for this peak shot, the shotgun. And there it is.
What Freak goes down. Beautiful juke right there. Diabolik playing with his opponent there. We'll go ahead and get that eliminated. Now he's got to immediately run. Look at how awkward this is right now for Salt. He's still got a ton of HP, though, and he's going to look for a reset of the fight. He's very low on ammo as well. This is another one of those scenarios, Lupa, where Salt has to win this. This is an all-in fight. If he disengages, what does he have to his name? Some SMG ammo?
You even see there, he forgot he ran out of materials. He tried to build to protect against Zate's push, and it wasn't enough.
Diggy is at 4 limbs right now, so this would be a 5th elim to earn 2 points this game. Diggy peeking. Does he decide to pop the medkit? It doesn't appear so as of yet. He wants this fight. I think he's worried about his opponent potentially dropping the storm down to just 16 HP to build up.
It's too late to pop that medkit. He's got to go for the elimination.
Look at how quick. Oh,
he gets it the last second.
The trap elim, and there he goes. Diggy with 5 elims in the last moment. A brilliant trap there.
Earlier on. Gets Johnny inside Tomato. You can have people that will capitalize on your build if you're very high. They use explosives to drop your structure down and catch you off guard as you're falling in. Those eliminations are big, too, because you take people out of their towers, you reset structure, and that means that you can decide what to build there if you take that position. They could be in really good spots. These players are going to have to move northwest here.
That was three. That's 3 for FaZe Replays, putting him at 1 point this game.
A replay from earlier. So we can make a play. He can make a push, and Turkey Lips trying to get the third party from the top of the building, taking the purple AR tap fire shots.
Every player with 3 plus elims has been eliminated.
They're shot!
Turkey Lips
getting his third elim there. That gives him a point for this round. Saint going down outside of that. An animal gets eliminated as well. Turkey Lips securing that one. That's his 4th elimination. One more will put him at 2 points, Jack. But he's got to take a second here to heal.
Yep.
And hopefully nobody heals
that. He's the only player still in contention with eliminations. Turkey Lips making monster plays right now. He's got players in front of him again.
It's like Punisher has basically 0 HP. All he needs to do is breathe on him, funny, and gets another elimination. Punisher actually goes down to Brandon, and everyone moving in there. But right now, what's funny, everybody was just forced north,
he's
and now they're from south.
He's gonna trip. Oh, what
are
a
you kidding
out?
Me, dude?
Oh no, Turkey Lips! What a play! Uses that new double barrel to blow up that wall in front of him, and just like that, he says, Bozy, my friend, no. That ain't happening. Gets the high ground, and now he's looking for the retake of this engagement. What a play to dodge the trap.
9 players left. Everyone that's left alive now has at least 1 point.
That launch pad looks so juicy.
Just outside the zone. I would bet you in this situation, Song will push with that and utilize it.
Zone's going to push that way.
He's in a great spot for it. He's going to get there ahead of everybody else. Here it comes.
He can wait and then use that at like the last second. Watch. Boom. High ground.
Fly with it.
He might hit it again.
Come back. He's trying to get ahead. He does realize somebody's there. Doesn't know that it's 72 hours. Now Brandon's using it. That might be one of the most used launch pads in this game.
With 6 of him. How has he done this with just 70 HP? No!
He's getting caught outside the zone. The tick, and he
earned himself another point, though, for top 10. Yep. Posey now on the high ground. Building on up. Top 5 players now. Posey in the top 5. Needs 1 more limb to earn a point, though, for eliminations this game.
Below. He knows at least one player is trapped inside there. Kind of trying to poke a little bit, maybe get a reveal on somebody and see if he can. He might even be able to provoke.
That's not held up by a lot.
A majority is outside the zone, too, so he won't be able to build and reinforce it. If somebody sees that, they can take him all the way down, but he's going to move before we even get to that point. He wants to get involved with these fights. There's a chance that he could get a third party kill on somebody that's not watching. It's elimination and.
No mats.
72 hours down.
Look at the rest of his inventory, though. Look at the med kit, the chug jug.
Dual drum guns.
That's all you need, I guess.
72 Hours probably looking to play for the very last circle to close, but having no builds remaining is going to be really tough. There is somebody inside there, the drum gun. Hold down that left mouse click and see if he can knock in. Move around the outside. He's going to try and make a play. A flank.
Are you kidding me?
72 using the storm to hide and gets the elimination on Psalm.
One versus one. Two players remaining. 72 Hours trying to stay alive. He's got no builds left.
No builds
it's
left.
Brandon who's close. Only 31 HP. If this goes down to a heal fight, 72 Hours wins it. Without a case, but there's the engagement trying to build on up. A quick shotgun blast. The second comes in as well. Brandon down to just 54 HP. 72 Hours popping minis. The zone's closing on in. He's got
to
go for this
push
right now. Brandon dropping out in. 72 Hours into the zone.
Oh, are you kidding me?
With 3 HP.
72 Hours shows why he's one of the best players out right now, making the choice earlier before this engagement to push out the storm. And yet again, spraying that drum gun, man, comes in clutch every time.
He used two drum guns, Stan,
give them
after
to me
the first three games. 72 Hours with that victory, Royale. But then as we move towards the bottom, 2 points is top 16. Remember, our top 33 move on to that finals on Monday. Ladies and gentlemen, game at number four, our final match of the night. Who will be our top 33 to qualify for Monday's $1.5 million grand finals?
Final week of Summer Skirmish, Jack, and here we go, game four.
Is it
some noise in the house here, please?
I like it, I love it.
As we fly in, you're going to see players starting to jump out. A lot of people jumping out very early, trying to look for a spread, maybe greasy, flush. See people pushing across east and northwest immediately. Every single POI, and even the locations that don't have a label on them, we have nicknames and stuff for them, but I feel like everywhere is hot right now.
Yep.
There's an even spread of players across the entire map, but that's not necessarily the case in every POI. Even last game we saw Tilted had a number of people drop in it very early. We've had some of these POIs that are larger retail and Pleasant have a couple players drop at them. You see in your bottom right there.
Ready before they could get close.
Here, Flame and Povzy. The third party, though, Flame gets a shot on Pose, gets the elimination. He's got to immediately build and defend himself. Does not have a lot of build left, though.
He just ripped it to go. And Flame's going to try to follow us up and get out in time.
Buffer up against
okay.
that. Even minis will,
okay.
Won't be enough. It's the boogie bomb.
What?
Nibs now dancing for his life.
Ripmate's got to go for this.
Pushing in the shotgun, gets him a shield tag. 24-21. Can't land it. Nibs gets him. 17 HP.
I'm mad for him.
80 HP right
to
now.
To be completely clear, no matter what happens to 72 Hours in this game, the man's qualified for Monday.
Oh yeah, he's good.
He's good. Sitting pretty in first.
Ooh,
he's done. Yeah,
gets the drop on him, but you don't come away from that upset.
No. What Serverzo was doing that whole time was he was dropping down that structure to where there was only one area left that he could see for. Unfortunately, wasn't able to follow it up with the Elim himself. This was Horrify. He used double C4s to eliminate his opponent in the new building in Tilted.
We'll go for the shot.
Doable try, something fancy there. He's really looking for a quick little snipe.
It looked like a head shake of frustration at the end.
Call that an ogre twitch.
Five in one, that little area, and that's going to move soon. They're all going to run into each other because the push out to the river right there, Jack, it's super exposed. There's not a whole lot of coverage. You have to move across the river. Horrify goes down to a maze.
Had three elims and one total point.
Hysteria gets elimination on Regan 57, who's trying to build up, trying to keep himself protected, but it looks like the quick placement edit from Hysteria, that kind of angled wall, that's all it takes. Snood and Ashen pushing in above him as Hysteria's cleaning up the remnants of his opponent down there. Smacking it. You see a lot of players, if the walls, the surfaces are not there, so they're going to knock him out. And if he's trying to can himself up in there, he'll immediately replace him. Now, it looked like Hysteria is looking to pick up an elimination or two in there.
Yep. Now, I don't know if Hysteria actually has any points so far, but he has a loadout this game to do it. And he knows that as well. He's got the launch pad. Look at the double triple C4 coming on in. He is making it rain C4s, and Jack is frustrated. I can promise you that.
Power out with a shotgun. Rocks coming in on Nibs. Shoots around that corner. Wow, the block out there at the last second wall. Just preventing any damage from the rocket.
He's got the high ground, and he's got rockets on the high ground. Somehow falls down. He knocks himself down. This could spell disaster. And it does exactly do that. Oh, he's kicking himself with that one. Rockets himself down. Breaks his own structure, which drops him below. And just like that.
Rocket. Look at that simultaneous rocket traits. LeVake shot the rocket. As Nibs' rocket was going out, LeVake shot the rocket as well. It's simultaneous rocket fire. Now Saint, very low HP, trying to build up. He's putting himself as high as he can right now. I believe he's not only is he getting third party by somebody, you heard the snipe shot a second ago.
But see, there he
he's
got
1v1 against Sofa as well. Trying to edit Sofa.
Dude, that was brilliantly done by Sofa.
Pyramid play to cap him inside, and then the edit and replace.
And Sofa's an example of one of these guys that I've really heard of him.
21, and the fall. Landjock gets the fall damage elimination.
I just
wanted
to go compliment him.
And it shows. Landjock, we just watched a second ago. You gave him a good luck charm.
A limb.
Sitting on 6 eliminations. This could be number 7.
So give him 3 points.
Give him 3 points.
Trying to spray on through. This is for trying to place a trap, but it wasn't his wall. That was actually the enemy placing the trap. Trying to find an open wall to shoot. He's getting third party as well.
27 HP left.
Oh my no!
After this is when it starts to move. Now this is Morgas just a moment ago.
He missed.
Oh. Mid-air.
Wow.
SMG spray off the bounce pad there. His opponent missed the first jump, jumped up on top and had the reposition.
Morgas is in the zone, taking a ton of damage. Finally make it on out. He's gonna get shot down too. This could be the ending here for our friend Morgas.
Any sort of surprise. Now, they just realize no one else is in there right now. But he knows there's people around. X is still sitting here, sitting just as good as he was before.
Yep.
He might be distant from the next safe zone, but he does have the bounce pad. You see right there on the street, somebody flying in.
Those
C9 blind making a move early, trying to get in the next safe zone, or at least a position right next to
him. He's literally building height just to bounce pad.
Here it comes. Yep.
Oh,
the shots on the way in.
Well, that was blind just returning the favor. And in that situation, I love that play. Give up the high ground, just mini, play that low ground.
The number of players there in one by ones right next to each other right now. X is moving down, I think, the goal here. He's sitting on 6 limbs. One more is 7, which is 3 points. He's top 12 right now. I shouldn't have said anything either, Jack. I feel bad.
Think that was one limb away from another point and two more positions away from another point for being top 10. So two points missed out on if he can just stay alive a little bit longer.
Look at the HP of Blind as he moves in. He actually just jumped in. One HP. I was commenting on it again. Jack, did you pass the curse to me? Jack,
I did.
Blind had one HP, starting to move in, and got caught off guard. Nib's going to try. Oh,
go for it all.
Dropping in. Prodigy Aces getting eliminated.
He's got two elims. Prodigy Aces is racking up the score right now. He drops to Kuros.
So many of these players have so few HP left. We're down to the top three. Nibs drop down, takes fall damage.
Wheats
five
is nearby.
Elims for Wheats.
If Wheats gets these last two elims.
Within the 7 and the win. Nibs pushing through. Wheats goes down. Courage, you need to stop saying
I really need to stop, man. I'm sorry.
This is a note for tomorrow. 1v1 here.
Fulmer trying to play this high ground, spraying on down with this drum gun. He sees the campfire, which basically gives away exactly which 1v1 this player's in. Still a whole nother zone to go. This isn't like the other games where it's kind of ending with a heal off. They still have so much time until that kind of moment comes on through.
Fulmer's trying to move across above and maybe catch this last player underneath him on rotation. Catch him off guard and try and get the elim. The number of rounds, though.
Look at
Nibs' ammo. Look at
material,
Nibs'
ammo.
He is stacked. And Fulmer's sitting on basically nothing.
Yep.
Fulmer's accuracy, the timing of these shots need to be absolutely perfect. Now Nibs can essentially spray at this moment.
Can we go back to Fulmer for a second possibly to see exactly what he's got in his inventory? Because you see, I don't think either player is healing.
12 builds, no healing. He's got 2 spike traps, maybe something else in the trap slot, we can't tell.
Yep.
But so few rounds for anything.
Yep.
Less than 100 rounds.
This is
right
a rough, rough spot to be in. Neither player has heals. Who will be the aggressor here?
Fulmer did an edit and reset it so that he could watch the wood come in and kind of try and look through, see if he can spot this player on rotation. Somebody's going to have to make a play. Fulmer's waiting for the last second. He's above. You can hear the pickaxing from the player underneath. 1v1, match
Fulmer,
4.
I think he's going to just go for it. Drop down and go. 3, 2, 1. First edit. Second layer. Third layer. Trying to spot where he is. Nothing yet. Here comes the spray. He's in the 1v1. The spray down. Down to 40 HP. The clock is ticking. He's got to make something happen. He knows 10. He's tagged the health. He tagged the HP. He knew he had the advantage. That's all he needed to do. Beautifully done. Had barely anything to his name. So, yeah, you'll see it again here. The zone closes on in. Nibs tries to push out to catch his opponent off guard. Doesn't happen because immediately it's just awkward. The player's just above him. Now he's trying to out-heal. How to out to the damage, and it just wasn't enough. He drops to the zone. GG.
Unbelievable.
I'm not surprised to see him at the top. I'm not going to lie, Lupo.
7 eliminations, 8 total points from Liquid 72 hours. One of the best players out there right now. Morgoth, somebody we kept our eyes on quite a bit. 11 elims.
And that top spot to make it on in. Now onto page 2. Remember, top 33 make it in.
Dremon,
who was landing at Westworld, that outer city outside Paradise Palms. 7 elims. He only had 1 point. But guess what? The aggressive early game plays.